And to Sean Payton, the whole deal, everything?
Well, I was excited for us. I was excited for Sean. I mean, it's, you know, look, I'm in charge of the draft, so more draft picks for our staff and our team, and that's exciting. So, you know, looking forward to getting to work a little bit more in the first round.
How important was it to get the draft pick this year? There was some talk, depending on what team it was, it might be a 2024 first rounder. How important was it for you to get it this season?
Look, I think the discussions were, you know, wherever we got it, we were going to be fine with it. So,
as far as, like, discussions with Mickey, I mean, obviously you're out in the loop with everything. Was it a process that came together quickly? Was it something with Sean in Denver that had been days in the works?
You know, when I got involved, it was just in the last couple of days. But I'm sure Mickey and Sean and maybe Denver were in discussions long before I got involved. So, I mean, I was involved, but, look, that's a Mickey question, to be honest with you.
Everyone has different opinions on the compensation, but as far as you were involved, can you explain the process and maybe why it's hard to get the compensation, I guess, everyone?
Look, again, those are Mickey questions. I'll be honest with you. There's no Mickey questions. They're above my pay grade. I know that I felt in my studies, I thought it was really good compensation. That's what I'll give you my opinion. I thought it was really good compensation.
Did you set the bar at, I mean, again, your opinion, at a first-round draft pick? Was that what you thought?
I felt like it was worth that, at least, yeah.
I know you have a close relationship with Sean. Have you talked to him through the process and throughout any of this? Or what is, you know, I guess your status, the two of you all communicating still?
No, I have not talked to him. The last time I saw him was in Arizona. I think a bunch of us had dinner with him, but that's the last time I talked to him.
Did it start to feel like maybe it wasn't going to happen this year?
There was a moment that we thought it might not happen. So, again, I wasn't involved with all these conversations. That was, again, above my pay grade, and that was between Mickey and Sean and the Denver Broncos. And on the outside, I mean, it felt like it, but I'm glad we got it done.
Jeff, how much more flexibility do you guys feel like you have now that you do have that first-round pick? Does it open up more options? Just kind of, does that affect things?
Well, it does. I mean, it doesn't really change our process as it relates to the draft. I mean, we're always going to evaluate every single player as if we had a top five pick, a 15th pick, or a 29th pick. So it doesn't really change the way we do things or the way we approach the draft. But it does give us more flexibility. It gives us at least one more good player this year that we can add to our football team. We're excited about that.
Jeff, when you have four coaches on the staff here, how much does that help you with just the information gathering process?
It helps a ton, to be honest with you. That was by design. We volunteered those coaches. They volunteered. We nominated them. And we'll get great information from each of them. I think the process that they go through, they're installing, they're sitting in the meeting rooms with those guys. That's more access than I'll ever get with them in terms of time with these players. I always liked coaching the Senior Bowl if we ever had the opportunity. I did it once in Miami. We had great access to the players. You really need time with players to really understand who they are and what their capacity to learn is. And just a little bit behind closed doors really helps. So having four coaches here is going to help us.
Do you prep them kind of like, you know, hey, ask them these questions, take these kind of notes, like you tell them kind of what to look for?
Sure, yeah, absolutely. We give them a little cheat sheet, and these are the things that we need to know, and they'll go through it and ask those questions, and hopefully we'll get the answers.
Did you feel like it was important for the organization to get the Sean Payton situation done and not have it sort of hanging over the team all of this coming football season? Was that important in the building?
We're on to Dennis Allen and his staff, and you know we're the New Orleans Saints, and who am I to say, you know, was it important? I mean, look, I got a job to do. We all have a job to do, and and we're going to go do it.
Jeff, what do you enjoy the most about being here at the Senior Bowl?
At the Senior Bowl,
yeah,
well, I love having the opportunity to sit down with the player. You've been studying these players, and sometimes 2 years ahead of the time you get a chance to really draft them. So, and for me, I didn't go to the East-West game this year. This is the first time I've been able to sit down and talk to a player, you know, person to person, getting to know them, asking them tough questions, getting some answers that I've had questions on for, you know, months and months. And it's not just me; it's our staff, all of our coaches, and our scouts getting those questions answered. And then we sit around and we powwow on on the things that we've learned from the day, and that's exciting to get those answers.
So when you're doing the interview process for the first time, what are some of the traits you want to see out of these players?
Self-awareness, you know, where they are in the world, you know, I mean, intelligence. Those are probably the two most important things we're looking at. Just as a, again, we're getting 15 minutes with them. Sometimes I call it the speed dating rounds, and you get four at a time, and you got to really kind of get in there and ask these questions, and then they're on to the next date. So, but those are two things that we're looking for.
Any more emphasis than normal this year on the quarterback position at all?
Again, our process really doesn't change. I mean, you know, when you had Drew, I mean, you kind of knew you were pretty much taken care of in that regard. And so, you know, we have, you know, one free agent quarterback and a practice squad quarterback under contract. So we do take it a little bit more serious this year because we need to find one.
What Jeff, is your thought process on the quarterback? Is it just kind of, you know, early in the draft, do you feel like you can find guys in value rounds? Like just kind of your opinion on drafting. I mean, you drafted Book before, just your thought on,
It all depends. You got to have the right traits. You got to have the right traits. You got to have the right intelligence. Quarterback in the history of the game is generally you have to take one early. The Tom Brady's haven't really been out there in the sixth round very often. We're able to acquire one in Dallas, Tony Romo in free agency, and you know that's a little bit of, you know, luck of the draw. But you have to usually select the really good ones early. There's a reason why they're up there in the top of the draft. But you're looking for traits. You're looking for processing speed, accuracy, you know, all the traits that you're looking for. So I don't know that, you know, right now we're just gathering information on the quarterbacks, on all the quarterbacks. Again, it's the first time we've ever had a chance to talk to them. But we've seen all the tape. We've evaluated the player. Now we're evaluating the person.
Jeff, there's some teams that like to take a swing at that every couple years. It sounds like you like to be a little bit more deliberate and ask to be maybe the right guy. Like, do you have a philosophy on that? Or?
Yeah, it has to be the right guy. I mean, you know, you just don't want to be, you know, throwing darts. I mean, you need to be a lot more accurate and decisive on who the person is. And because I think we fall in love with quarterbacks really fast and we fall out of love with quarterbacks very fast. So you have to be very deliberate, in my opinion.
Who's we? The media or even teams
in general? Teams in general, yeah, sure. Everybody does.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How much further would you, like, if every other position, you know, if they're great as a 90, you take them now, how much further will you go up for a quarterback? Like, will you take a third round graded quarterback in round two? I mean, is that how you have to do it almost? Or?
Well, you have to put yourself in a position to get the players that you love. And in the scenario that you're talking about, that's a very hypothetical scenario. You have to put yourself in position to get the players. You got to trust your scouts. You got to trust your coaches. You got to trust your evaluations. And if you love someone, you know, either you love him in the second round, probably, you know, you got to go get him. In other words, you got to go get him. So that'd be my philosophy.
I know that he had a year award coming up. What's your opinion on the season
I think Chris had a great season, to be honest with you. Look, we were a little bit in flux with the quarterback position early on, and he kept making plays, and he really kind of exactly what we thought he would be, very polished, very fast. The fact that he had to be the number one guy when Mike went down early on in his rookie season, I thought he performed very well. Extremely excited about Chris and his future here. As much as we are, Trevor and Alante and DeMarco, we're excited about all our draft picks. We think they got huge upsides. You know, so, you know, the answers, you know, rookie of the year, I mean, yeah, it'd be great to, you know, throw on his resume. And I'm rooting for him. If I had a vote, I'd vote for him. So I'm excited about all the rookies.
Do you remember anything from the scouting process on him that just, like, jumps out to you almost a year later?
Yeah, the fact that he's a very polished person as well as a polished receiver. He was very smart. His kind of personality kind of translated to what I saw on the field. He's a very competitive person. He hates to lose. He's obsessed with winning, which I love. He's a very smart football player. You saw that on the tape. I drafted his coach at Ohio State, so I had some really good inside information on the kid, and I've been I've been knowing about Chris for probably longer than he was draft eligible. So nothing really surprised me about Chris's year this year.
Jeff, what about Peyton?
Sorry. As far as, you know, you're busy with your season, but Tulane had a great season. They got a couple of players here. Have you had a chance to talk to them, to look at them, you know, Spears and Williams, and just maybe some general thoughts?
Yeah, look, I went to two games live, both players. They had many more than just two. They had some really good players this year. I thought Willie did a phenomenal job with his team this year. It was fun to watch. It's a great atmosphere at Tulane. Spears is a really good player. He had a great day today. Had two big long runs, I think a catch and a run and a run. Did really good in the pass protection today. Williams was on the opposite end and some of those one-on-one drills and did a really good job in the blitz protection or blitz. So I think they're both very good prospects. I think they're both intelligent. I didn't personally talk to those guys. I know my staff did yesterday morning and then I think we talked to Tajay tomorrow night, but excited to talk to him individually.
I was going to ask you about Peyton Turner. Obviously, injuries is one part of it, but what do you think? Like, does he feel like the guy you always thought might be a year two, year three bloomer type, or is there some kind of hump he still needs to get over?
Yeah, he definitely has a hump to get over. There's no doubt. Peyton, you know, he's had the injury bug. He's got to get over that. He's got to get in really good shape starting the season. He's got to get his weight right. And, you know, we're looking – I still see a great athlete in there. He's just got to translate, get over the hump and being a really good football player. He's got to strain some more. I'm excited to see him healthy going into training camp. And he still has a couple of strides to go, a couple of steps to get to where he needs to get to.
Is he still a defensive end first who can move inside? I mean, is that kind of the
– I see him as a defensive end, absolutely.
Yeah. And then one other first-round pick, Trevor Penny, you guys got such a small glimpse of him. What do you still like about the potential there?
I think he could be a really dominant player in this league. Each exposure we got to Trevor was better than the previous exposure. That was in camp. That was in his first couple exposures in preseason. Then he gets hurt. Then he's out for 2.5 months. And then we started sprinkling him in as the jumbo tight end. The more he played, the better he got. The next game was better than the previous game. And then the game he started, I thought there were some holes that were really wide in the run game. He had one bad snap in the pass protection, but other than that, he was clean. Those are some really good signs of a very good football player in the future.
Jeff, what's the when you talk about traits you're looking at in quarterbacks, what are those? And can a player kind of separate himself from like the prototype talk when he's got some exceptional qualities?
Look, I sat down with Drew before he left. I said, I got to know this, you know, what makes you exceptional? He said processing speed, accuracy, getting the ball out. And so some of those are things you're going to learn watching the tape, and some of those you're going to learn by sitting down and studying tape with him and getting to know the kid. But those are just a couple. There's so many traits that you're looking for at the quarterback position, and some guys have all of them. Those usually go really early. Some guys you know, have a few of them, and you got to really, you know, really evaluate deep, get a deep dive on those guys and find out what, you know, what they're made of.
Do you have a difference in stylistic kind of quarterback you're looking for? Like if it's a guy, you know, the more running guys or the more drop back guys, do you care one style more than another?
Quarterbacking is one of those positions where it's an all-in evaluation. It's not just me as the college director. It's not just the coach as a head coach. It's an all-in. We're looking for a very consistent evaluation on the quarterback position. We have to all be in on that particular evaluation and say, hey, yeah, we all want this guy. So whether he's a running quarterback, you know, a dual threat quarterback, I mean, ideally, if you're asking me directly, I like the dual threat quarterbacks, but they got to be able to throw when they're hurt. You know, so when they can't move their legs, they got to be able to throw. But I do like the dual threats guys. So. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Jeff. Yeah.